Welcome back to Busy Dad's Workshop, and today we're going to talk about replacing power cords on AC powered tools. This here is a dual action polisher, probably the world's finest produced polisher right now for paint work. And this is the LHR21ES. This is an excellent tool, very well built. However, the power cord itself has a little bit to desire. So what we're going to do today is replace this power cord. Either you're going to replace it from a standpoint of it's broken, or you're going to replace it just to improve it. And so what we're doing to do today is improve it. And what I did is I went down to Home Depot, picked up a Husky 14 gauge 3-wire power cord, and we're going to replace this onto the tool. To replace a cord on a power tool, there's a couple different ways that you can do it. One is you can simply use quick crimp connects like this. I was never a big fan of these because I don't find them very reliable. And then you can also use solder like this, which is what I'm going to use today. So the first things that you're going to need here, of course, is a soldering iron. You're going to need some 60/40 electrical solder. The cord. For this tool, you'll need a Phillips screwdriver to open it up. And of course, we'll need some wire cutters to cut the wire off. And then some strippers. You can also use a blade for this. To get to the power connectors inside of the handle, you simply take out these four particular screws on this model. Okay, now the last screw is loose. Carefully remove the housing. And that gives you access to the connections. Okay, now that the case is open, we have to remove the cable. So one of the things that we're going to be keeping is the strain relief, and we also need to remove the tie down clamp here. And you'll see that this only has a black and white wire. That's because this is a 2-wire device and not a 3-wire. The third wire on this is a ground wire. With the way this is built, a ground wire is not required. So we're going to trim off this ground and use only the line and neutral connections. All right, so you can see here that Rupes used quick connects. Like I said, I'm not a big fan of these, so I'm actually gonna cut right on the edge of this so I get as much wire out of here as I can, as the wire coming into here is potted in resin, so I'm not gonna be able to actually replace the wire all the way up into the motor control. So we're gonna trim right inside the plastic just to keep as much wire as we can. And then pull out those little plastic bits. So here's the power wire that's left. So what we're going to do is strip this back and get it ready for solder. With the old cord out of the way, I've already replaced the strain relief, and since we are soldering this, we want to protect the wires once they are fully soldered. So what I'm also going to be using is heat shrink. Here you can use a heat gun, and if you don't have a heat gun, that's fine. You can always use a lighter. So what we're going to do is get ready to solder here. We're going to do one wire at a time. And the first thing you're going to do is twist the wire together just a little bit, just to hold it enough so that when you apply the 60/40 rosin core solder, that it will hold it. So here's our connection ready to go. And now we will solder that together. A tip for soldering is you hold the heat underneath the wire, and that will help the solder to flow into the conductors. So there's our first connection, and I'll go ahead and do the second. Okay, now that we have our solder finish on these two connections, it's time to put the sleeves on to protect the open connectors or conductors, and then we're going to go ahead and shrink those up. And as I mentioned, if you don't have a heat gun, it's okay, you can just use a lighter. Now that that's completed, all we have to do is put the strain relief back on and put the wire tie back on and reassemble. All right, so here we have our finished polisher. The cord's all put back together. It's a nice heavy duty cord, and we're ready to get polishing again on some paint. So I wanna say thank you to Kevin Brown of BuffDaddy.com. If you're looking for information on polishing paint, as well as looking for equipment such as the polishers and pads, definitely check out BuffDaddy.com for that information. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.